Hello everyone, welcome to a new video. Today's video is mainly focused on advanced players tips and tricks. So if you're a beginner or pretty much new to the game, these tips won't really affect you as much as it would affect advanced players that know the game. But you can also benefit from watching the video anyway. So let's get into it. First tip is diagonal movement with the two bags. If you hold two bags in this game, you can hold two bags, one you wear and one on your hand. The one you wear will affect your movement depending on how heavy and full it is. But when I pick a full bag, like the suitcases from the gang, La Bayena, I move really slowly. You pick any bag on your hand, it will affect you to the same speed. It doesn't depend on how full the second bag you're holding. When you pick another bag in your hand and you run straight forward like this, hold W and sprint, you run pretty slowly. But if you run sideways and hold W, like diagonally, you move faster. This also uses stamina. But if you're holding two normal bags, like you wearing a normal bag, it's not over 400 size and 300 weight. It's under the normal limit that you can get legitimately. But if you're holding a suitcase from the gang like this, it's a slightly different story, because the second bag doesn't affect you. With the gang suitcase, you can regenerate stamina faster than you use it while running straight forward, which is pretty handy for running away from cops, I guess. And you can combine this trick to move faster with the bunny hopping, so you can be hop faster instead of just this, and you can just be hop sideways like this. Not sideways, but diagonally. I hate that word, man. So the second tip I'm going to show you guys is this one. When you come over here to buy wheat seeds, the guy, his name is Barney Roman in East Dead Town. You probably came from this direction, like from Mid Dead Town or West Dead Town. When you come from there, you have to pick this lock to get through and jump over the fence and buy seeds. And when you do that, let me just show you real quick. When you do that and jump over the fence, buy from the guy, I have a suitcase full of stuff here. You can jump over the same fence this way. So you have to go all the way around or jump over this fence and into this tight alleyway again, which is not very convenient. I'm going to show you a way to get in and out pretty fast if you get the hang of the move anyway. The first way, which is what I use when I come in, is I crouch here, lean and jump through the gap. So you can pretty much just join a pixel of the fence through the gap in the gate and jump through it. And you can also do this, which we'll get to in a moment. Second way works both from there and from here. It's this area right here. You can jump and crouch and get in, and same thing over here. I suck today. Yeah, and this works with any backpack. Only thing is, you have to drop the backpack through that gap before you make the bad jump. So if I jump here, I can't jump over the gap. I can't make a high enough jump to clear this gap with the suitcase on, so I have to drop it through. You can jump and throw it if it's easier for you. Okay, and jump and crouch at the same time while holding W. That's a crouch jump. It's basically from CSGO, but reinvented it here. Okay, next tip is going to be using garage doors to get on top of roofs. This is a very easy way to climb onto rooftops and clear roads pretty safely. So even if you get seen or searched, you're on top of a roof, so You're not getting rich from there. All you have to do is open the garage door and jump on it while it's opening. You don't have to crouch, you just jump and hold the key to move into it. You should wait a little bit as well so it's even wider. And there you go, you just jump onto the rooftops. This does not work with the stink tree garages, sadly. That was the tip. Also, I did not say why this is useful or why you wanna do this. I will give you a context. If imagine it's nighttime right now and there's a police barrier right there or somewhere. You wanna clear this road and this road without being without risking getting searched or tased at night time. So you climb onto the roof and clear them without risking anything. Even if you get searched, just stay here until they run away and just jump off somewhere and yeah, make a run for it. And one of the best places you can do it with, it's right here. This one you can't own, but you can lockpick. I used to I always store my pet cops in here. I will make a video on how to get a pet cop or a police guy in a second. So you jump and crouch on this tube coming out of the AC unit and jump on top of the rooftop. Another thing around here is this area. If you want to escape from cops pretty quickly, you can jump from that hill on the jeep right there and then on this rooftop. You can get on here with the through this garage door like before I showed you, but this is a very quick way to just lose cops. And yeah, you can jump over here as well, make it that jump, but you need a runner perk fully upgraded for that to happen. This one is useless though, so don't bother using it. And yeah, that's about it. Next up is going to be how to skip a few gates, which can be lockpicked, but are if you basically don't have lockpicks on you, bobby pins, which are used to lockpick the gates. You can use these ways to skip some gates. This one you just have to jump on that hill onto this rooftop or onto this gate. It's harder with the gate though, so jump through here and you can already access that area. If you want another way, you can use this garage door to go on top. Wait a second. Okay, you can't really do anything with this. You can jump there on this fence and jump over that gate this way. This gate can't really be skipped, but you can just go on through here and just don't have to pick anything, or use this garage door as well, so you don't even have to pick that gate or touch it. This one is pretty simple. It's in West Dayton in the middle. You don't have to pick this gate at all, never, especially if you come through here. Just jump on, you see this large wooden planks thing frame, and this one at an angle, just jump through like this and jump again. You need to carry some speed or jump pretty late, so you make it over this without hitting it. And to go back, you just have to jump on this bench, come up, jump and crouch. It's pretty easy. You just have to practice these jumps before you rely on them in the real game while you're playing. So you just have to load the game, come into your save, come over here, practice some jumps at daytime preferably, so no cops can interrupt you. And yeah, once you're done, just reload, save, and have fun. If you want to skip this gate, you can jump on this car, jump on top of these wheels. There's an invisible barrier on top, so you're standing way on top of them. Then you have to jump on that ledge. We did not see that. Just jump like this, and you just walk on over it. If you want to go back, just use this hill to jump and crouch like that, and you can jump again from here. And while you're at it, I recommend you clear this road and this road like this from on top. You can also go through like this just on the ledge, then jump and crouch on that ledge, and then on the pipes, then jump and crouch on this roof. And you can have access on to this roof, that roof. Also, if you get stuck in there, there's no going back unless you have a bottle or a spray can. You can boost bug out of that area. But if you get stuck in there with nothing, you're pretty much done for. You have to reload your save file. You can also just go there, I guess. It's not useful by any means, but you can go here, pretty much useless. And you can drop bags in this corner. On the other corner, come and use this gap to transfer the stuff. Or you can get into here, drop a bag and use that gap or this gap to transfer drugs.
Hey, come over here, pal.
You can jump over a wall. Wait for them to fuck off. See, they went off. Then jump right back. You have to be careful when you use this trick, because they can just wait around and you can get caught like that.
Suspect on the
okay,
run.
We have them back on us. They're kinda close, but it should be fine. Just jump on the ambulance. They don't know what to do, just so they jerk around and you can just turn around. You can also use the sewer system to quickly escape from them, and as you can see, my FPS is shit down here, so I don't even use the sewer system. I don't have to use it to escape the cops because I'm a professional drug dealer. Here we are in Sector A. This gate is in Old Market at the entrance. Sometimes you get a dealer or a client standing right there behind this gate, so you don't really need to go over here and go all the way around. Just you can jump and crouch on this box right like this, come on, and then jump and crouch over the fence and then make a deal. To get back from here, you just do the same thing with this box, and you jump off from on top of that cylinder. And you jump and crouch, and when you're on top of this fence, if you want to stand on it like I did, you uncrouch on top of it while you're over it. You can also just move through like this, and you can go on top of this whole warehouse, I guess, even though you can just use these barrels to come inside on top. And to get on top of that, from here you can jump on the car, on this electricity box or whatever, and make your way over here. In the southeast of the whole map, in East Desert it's called, you see this first boulder, the large one on top of it. Or around it, you can see these holes on the kind of dug up areas. They're kind of sketchy. If you throw a bag or any item here, they kind of float around because it's probably level with the water outside. This allows for some funny stuff, like you can throw bags very high if you go under that surface and just throw it, you float. And yeah, that's a good throw, but see ya. It's kinda fun though. When you want to chill, just come in this area and just throw stuff forever. And you can do some pretty cool shit, like throw some dollar bills and they float around. It is floating, it's not just sending, it's floating. You can throw any item, like even drugs. You can throw drugs here with the same thing, and you can stand on them and make some invisible parkour. So yeah, this kind of fun thing to do. But yeah, just jump on that stuff and have some fun, I guess. I wanted to fill this whole thing, but I can use my time better than that. So this step is going to be using your hideout windows to clear a few locations, like in East Old Town warehouse right here. You can use these windows to kind of look outside into that road, and it's not very clear, but the most useful thing about this is you can spot the police barricade at night time if it is right there. There is a very useful bug you should know about. This works with any shop, any item, as I said. Come into any shop, and when you're here, first thing you want to do is find any item you want to get an impulse supply of. So in the convenience store it's probably sugar because it's already pretty low, so you want to have an impulse supply of sugar. Then you double click on that item you want to duplicate, and as you can see it's already spiked up to 941. So now you hold alt to you see alt plus drag is drag single, so like this you can drag single items from anything. I already fucked up. You hold alt and you move the sugar that we double clicked into the bag back into the shop. Then you can just get an empty supply of that item like you duplicated. To do this again with any other item, you just have to cancel, come back, and just do it again. Hold alt, don't forget to hold alt. I will show you what happens if you do not hold alt. Let's see, you put it back, it just goes to the normal size and you can do it again. So just have to come back. You can do this unlimited times with any item, so you can duplicate, let's see, sugar twice, three times. Jamie Walls, come here, do let's do Viagra because it's most common. And yeah, you can have 1315 boxes of Viagra. Double click on the bitcoins and hold alt and drag back. I got 742,001 bitcoin, which is kind of insane. With spray can, 682. Anyway, you get the idea. You can do it with anything to get unlimited supply of everything. Just keep in mind you have to have space for him to actually give you stuff to store the seeds you're gonna get. So you need the suitcase from the gang to actually duplicate the seeds, and the storage to get the seeds from him. So I'm not gonna lockpick that gate, I'm gonna use the trick I showed you at the start. Get suitcase through here. Where are you going? Just gonna just get stuck in there. Fucking perfect. First time you saw it in action though. Most common, you can do this only once, by the way, because once you cancel the guy just goes away. So you have to do it first try. Just double click on the skyscraper, drag back, and just, yeah, that's about it. Just drag skyscraper seeds. This is the best way to get skyscraper seeds. And yeah, you can drop the cash slightly dead, but when you come back you see it's not glitched anymore. And to fix that, you probably just have to update the suitcase with a shop by interacting with the shop like this and cancel, but whatever. Anyway, just updating him works fine. Can I do it please? Okay, so you get the idea. Just come into a shop, do something, do the bug if you want, and just cancel and go away. Fuck you. For this next bug, I'm going to use this hideout in West Dead Town warehouse. I have a lot of flasks in here and a shit ton of crystallizers. An advanced player will probably have this many crystallizers at the end game, especially when you're rich as f. For this tip, we're gonna go on top of the stuff and work from on top of them. And if you already know, you can't really jump in hideouts, you can only crouch. And you can get on top of this without jumping, and using shelves. You can put shelf here, shelf there, shelf there, shelf there, you get the idea, and just walk on top of them. If you get too high, like near the roof, you can just crouch. You can't really walk because they interrupt your movement or whatever. So yeah, you can put shelf there. This is just my hideout, it's pretty cramped, so you have to do the shelves from there. can do them anywhere. Like if I take this table out, just imagine a whole table like that. I put shelves like that and just walk on top of everything. And yeah, you can work from on top of everything. It's kind of more convenient, I guess. So to keep track of which crystallizers are done and which are not. Another trick or bug is how to transfer equipment like containers, mixers, laptops, anything you can put through this menu. Can put dryers, anything you can get from the pharmacy and laptop from the furniture store. We have 10 large let's do laptops. We have 3 laptops here and this many of that stuff, so you can come through here, you can lockpick stuff, but it kind of glitches around, so you don't want to do that while you're doing the bug. So do that. So I already lockpicked that door. You can't run like this. You can crouch either, but you can jump over walls like that, and you can open doors as well. You don't want to get in another hideout. You just want to from the outside just place the stuff, and you come inside. We have everything we put. If you get that, yeah, we have a lot more stuff than we started with in this hideout. Another trick is stacking containers and equipment. This is kind of useful to make compact setups like this one. We have two dryers on top of each other, pretty much stacked. And this works with containers like this. You can place them while they face the roots on shelves like these shelves. Only thing is that you have to work your way down from top to bottom. From top to bottom, because you can't place on top of it anymore. Like if you place it like that in phases, so you have to go from the top one, then under, then under, then under. I'm doing a shitty job right here, but get the idea. I did a much better job for this supermarket. I called it the supermarket because it was full of cocaine one day. It was just nuts, insane. Another tip for beginners, especially beginners that don't know this already. If you save the game on, let's say, Plata Oplomo, you get a 5-minute cooldown to save the game again. You can bypass that cooldown by saving in another hideout. Meanwhile, that cooldown just refreshes. So let's say you just saved the game right there. It's giving me a 5-minute cooldown, and then I forgot that I had another client waiting. I want to save the game before I quit again. So I save the game in another hideout, and yeah, pretty good to go. If you did not know that already, then you do not now. And yeah, it's pretty useful, very useful if you don't want to get the dealer or client bug that doesn't let you interact with them, which is kind of frustrating to get, to be honest. Just it's one dealer less than you could have had, basically. So yeah, I have 10 suitcases I want to store. I want to store a lot of suitcases into cupboards. So when you put 10 suitcases or any bag, it will take the same size as one full suitcase. Let's see, this is 10. Can put it's 400 size, and if we put that into a suitcase and drag it into the thing, it's also 400. If you drag it back, you get 10 and an extra bag. So this is how to store one extra whole bag. So to top it all off, I'm going to give you a clip of me retrieving like 27 suitcases from the gang. I have a lonely Gustavo right here. Sad. Feels bad being alone, man. Alright. Okay, I will show you the clip and you can have fun like that. This is the end of the video. If you enjoyed the video, drop a like, subscribe if you want to see more. And I will have a very good video soon. Very exciting video. Spoiler alert. I will show you in a second. It will use this website. That's 191 challenges. Sell the rocks for $15 more than your current prices. It's pretty brutal. Only small bag, no bag at all, no tab, no phone. Some cool stuff.
Check with their.